Alright, we're gonna have another go at it. Got my chip kind of where I want it to be. It's a new chip I'm using, so new tungsten, so I'm trying to figure out if it's any good or not. Different brand. So far it's not holding up very good. We'll see how long it lasts. Something went boom down there. Tungsten just about disappeared, which I kind of figured was happening. Tungsten isn't holding up like it should be. Ooh, hot too. Back kind of where I want it. Kind of leaning off to the one side a little bit. Yeah, we'll see how that works. Board rod in it. hard to tell what's going on in the port down there. I can't see. It's not normally the angle I weld at, so I can't see how big the hole is, but it looks like I'm not welding like I should. There's a little hole down, buried down in there. I can't get to it. Try to melt it out and get into it again. Looks like my tungsten stayed up that time. Must be getting broken in. Try this again. Got where I needed to that time. Hot, hot, hot. Gosh. I had to weld way down in here. I just poured the metal in and let it kind of flow in there. So it's in there. See how the extra stuff is way down in here. Trying to get that to stick over there, but it's all contaminated and it's stick. I'll have to come back over here and build this up across the top after I get more on it. Obviously the powder coat got there. Okay, now I gotta move this head around. I gotta go over to the bad part over here. I'm not sure how much I can have that we can see it, because I gotta be able to get in to weld this thing. It's really hard to weld it at an off angle like I'm doing right now. It's also hot too, because I'm laying over the top of the head. Alright, so let's move that. Let's see what we can do here. Around. try to get us where I don't knock the camera over again. All right, we'll try over there. See if you can see what I'm doing. Probably gonna block the shot a lot of that. Try to slide the more angle over there. All right, we'll see what happens there. Welding at 275 amps right now, too. Just at full throttle. Stop and get a reference to where I'm at. Set those pieces together where I belong. tungsten is disappearing. Top end tungsten kind of gone. You get all them weird colors going on, that usually means your tungsten's going away. Bend the cup. You know, it's a 300 amp torch. You put 300 amps in your tungsten, it burns it right off. Try this again. Probably one little better now with tungsten a little more. Oh better once you can see what the hell you're doing. Get the angle you can work. And the tungsten's up where it belongs. It was a lot better when the tungsten's up there where it belongs. Pretty good turret on there. I think I melted some of the head away a little bit. I can live with that. Take the head around so I get to over here where I need to weld. I don't know why that went all out of focus there, but it did. So you can see where I welded right over there. Oh. let's see if I can get this over where you see it now. Change cam position number 3. Go back up on the bench again. Maybe get you a good top view where you can see what's happening. As long as I don't melt the camera away, we're all right. sure if it's kind of built up. Hopefully it's enough. A little low over here in the corner. I need to really have a flange over here so I can prepare what I'm going to do. Level so you can see what the hell you're doing. It's very important. Get a level working surface. Let's see, you gotta get something you can see. Charcoal off of this, I can see what the actual aluminum looks like. Under it. Right there, where I'm at. lock goes. Trying to burn all that crap out of the powder coat and stuff and try to get a surface to work from. Guessing what level is. Don't really know. Alright, I think we got enough in there now. Definitely is warmed up. And we'll let it kind of cool off here. Come back and look at it a little bit. There we go for now. Okay, we got the head in the oven right now. Just took it up to 450. Let that kind of bake for a little bit. Supposed to shut off before 450, but I'm gonna knock it down about 400. We'll let that run for about 10 minutes, let it normalize. And that will let the head kind of just cool overnight and get the whole thing up at one temperature and let it cool down slowly, and that helps stop warpage and cracking and stuff like that. Kind of stress relieves it slightly, not a lot, but a little bit. All right, for my filming, I was using this, what the hell do they call these things? Neutral density filters, that's what they were. So I had the two high ones put together. So according to them, that's 25%, 50%. So I had the 50% and the 25 put together, or it was 12.5 was a low, I don't know. Whatever, I took the darkest two and put them together. So I had these stacked up. So you have clear, medium, and dark. So dark is dark. So put those two together. Had them stacked up. That's why you had that tunnel effect going on. So we'll see what that looks like. I'm just playing around there, so don't know what it did or not did. I wasn't watching the video. I was welding. So I'm using a bunch of these sticks of a rod here. Now this is the small stuff. This is what I was using right here. 3/32 hard rod. I use hard rod because I'm going to be machining it. That gives you a nice hard surface to machine to. If you use the soft stuff, which is your 40-43 over here, it's real gummy, soft, strips real easy, and machines like crap. So I don't use too much of it. So I used a bunch of these. Now I was holding this close as I was putting it in with my welding gloves over here, which are these Kevlar cutting gloves. I like them quite a bit. You can get real close. So I was welding at whatever temperature I was that close when I was pulling in a puddle. So how many of these did we use today? That's an older one. There's another one. That was one. Either that wasn't one. That's one. So I wasn't keeping track how many sticks I was using, but it's 2, 4, 6, 9. Looks like I went through at least 9 of them. Not counting the ones that hit the floor. I'm sure there's some down there. Okay. So anyway, that's how much I used. That's still hot. So use quite a bit of it. Now for the Welgood welding material, I use the 5350 or 5556. This is a military spec rod. It has the same properties of both the soft and the hard, but it has more tensile straights, so it's a little bit harder yet. But it has a yield strength of like the 40-43 does, so it gives you the best of both worlds. But it costs twice as much than anything else. So I only use that when I need maximum strength. The 40-43 you use for fins and stuff like that, or areas that are cracking real bad, because it doesn't shrink that much. And it's kind of stretchable too, so it doesn't crack as much. So you use the 40-43 in the crack area, and then once you want to build up for strength, or on any kind of machine surface, you go to the harder rod. Anyway, there's a lot of different rattles out there. Those are the three I use. So this is my old welding machine here. So
and 306 Navy from Eltec. For you Navy guys over there, it came off the Tawala right there. They got the number on it. So, military surplus. There you go. So, some of you guys might be on that ship. So, I've had it for probably 15 years now. It's a big dinosaur. One thing about dinosaurs, you can weld all day with them. Now, we just put new welding plugs in here because I burned up the other pair, because these are only 50 amp rated and we're pulling probably 125 to 150 amps for this machine running. So it, this is the size wire we're using, but it melts the wire, gets it really hot. So, could have electricity. All right, well anyway, that's what we're doing on this. So we'll see how this welding turned out. If it didn't turn out good, maybe someone knows something better to use. So I don't know how many of these to use, so I just stacked two of them together. We'll see. I'm sure it wasn't worth the crap, but who knows? Somebody might like it. And it looks like we're stabilized at about 456 over there. So I'll shut that off in a couple minutes. I can actually feel a breeze in here. It's a hot damn night. I got the fan going on in the front room. I got the back door wide open, letting the air fumes go through. A lot of fumes when I shut the welder off. So I have it all bottled up when I'm welding so I can breathe all the good stuff. But anyway, that's what's going on for here. So I'm up, I'm done for the night, and tomorrow we'll see if I work on that head or something else. But I gotta remachine. Now I gotta machine everything. So we'll see how good of a welding job I did. That's it for now.